ADRDL, Animal Disease Research and Diagnostic Laboratory. So every state has something like this, a laboratory that's dedicated to animal health, and they help the animal producers, the animal owners, and the veterinarians in those states answer questions about animal disease issues and animal health issues. We have an R in our name, besides the diagnostic lab, that indicates we do some research. We really specialize mostly on livestock here at SDSU in this lab because of the part of the country we're in. A lot of beef, a lot of dairy, a lot of swine, sheep and goats.
The research in my lab addresses the human and animal health from a perspective of one health. The idea is that human, animal, and environmental health are tied to each other, and we need to address all these three things as a whole.
It's very common that we'll work with human disease issues that originate in animals. And some of those disease issues, we start with the animals, and that's where the problem first comes up.
We are unique in a way when compared to other diagnostics labs, because our lab combines research and diagnostics. So the focus of our food safety lab is to keep track of the foodborne pathogen incidents both in humans as well as animals. So we are a Food and Drug Administration affiliate lab for state of South Dakota. In that capacity, we do multiple things. One is we go into grocery stores, buy random meat and other samples, bring them to the lab and test for presence of bacteria like Salmonella, E. coli, Listeria, and Campylobacter. These are the four main bacteria that we test for.
Well, so this all started with a call from the Department of Health, a couple of illnesses in people. They identified an unusual strain of Salmonella.
The strain's name is called Salmonella bongeri, and it is an atypical strain of Salmonella that you usually never see infecting people.
The health department, one of their jobs then is to try to figure out where this infection came from. So they will interview the patients and talk about food sources and what animals do they contact. And it turned out that these two households had both had bearded dragons as pets in the household. As the state public health vet, when an animal thing is involved, then they reach out to me. And so we determined that we could try to get some samples from those animals and then kind of see, okay, is it the same thing in the animals as it was in the people?
And then what we found was that the bongeri we isolated from the pet and the kids were 100% identical. So it's a interesting case where both Department of Health, our lab, and work together, and we use the information from previously reported cases, and we could tie it all together. ADRDL is a unique lab because being in the university gives us additional leverage in terms of being able to use the high-performance computing capacity on campus, graduate students developing new tests, and then working with the staff in the diagnostic lab.
The ADRDL really helps SDSU in a lot of different ways. It provides research opportunities for our researchers who can get grants then and hire students.